मतलब क्या है अयोध्या का? मतलब अ मतलब नहीं, युद्धा मतलब जहाँ कभी युद्ध नहीं होता है, जहाँ पर कभी युद्ध नहीं होता है। युद्ध कहाँ पर होता है? जहाँ ईर्षा द्वेष अहंकार, वहीं पर युद्ध होता है। लेकिन भगवान का जो धाम है वो अप्राकृत नित्य है, इसलिए इसका नाम है अयोध्या, मतलब जहाँ पर कहीं ईर्षा द्वेष, इसलिए उसका नाम वैकुंठ है, वैकुंठ, जहाँ पर किसी तरह का कुंठा धर्म नहीं है, इसलिए स्थान का नाम है अयोध्या। यद्यपि हमें दिखता है ये साधारण रूप में, हमें क्या दिखता है जैसे घर द्वार मकान दुकान, लेकिन तत्वतः जो भगवान का धाम है, कहते श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु जीवे दया करी सपार सदस्य धाम सहवतन। जैसे भगवान आते हैं वो अकेले नहीं आते, भगवान अपना धाम अपना परिकर अपना सब कुछ लेकर के उसी जगत से यहाँ आते हैं, इसलिए इसका नाम अयोध्या। और इसका नाम क्या? बोले अवध। अवध का मतलब क्या? बोले अ मतलब नहीं, बध मतलब मरना, जहाँ पर कोई नहीं मरते हैं, भगवत धाम में थोड़ी कोई मरते हैं, वो भगवान का सबके सब भगवान का नित्य परिकर है, इसलिए नित्य परिकर होने के नाते यहाँ पर कोई मरते नहीं। इसलिए बताया न जत्र रोग न जरान मृत्यु न आरती न उद्वे, जहाँ पर कोई बूढ़ा नहीं होते हैं, जहाँ पर कोई दुख नहीं, जहाँ पर कोई मरते नहीं, जहाँ पर कोई इससे सबके सब परे है, इसलिए इसका नाम अयोध्या है और इसका नाम अवध है।
हरे कृष्णा अंडर द गाइडेंस ऑफ गुरु गौरांग, द प्लेस वी हैव कम, दिस इज अयोध्या। अ मीन्स नॉट, योध्या मीन्स वॉर, सो दिस प्लेस देर इज नो वॉर, देर इज नो नेवर एनी बैटल, दैट्स व्हाई दिस प्लेस इज कॉल्ड अयोध्या। Also another name for this place is Avadha. A means not, Vadha means killing or death. So this place is beyond death. So this place is completely situated in spiritual world. This is Vaikuntha. Vai means not, Kuntha means anxiety. So in this place there is no anxiety. No birth, no disease, no old age, no death. Completely free from the four defects. And this is, there is no hatred here. No envy is there, no lust, greed, anger, madness, envy, all these six defects, they don't affect this place. Therefore, this is the Ayodhya. So, externally, Maharaj is telling that we may see that there are so many shops, so many streets, less violence, but actually, this is a completely transcendental city. This is where the Lord Ram eternally resides. So, this is actually in the spiritual world. Just like there are seven cities in India which bestow liberation. So Ayodhya is one among them. Avanti.
Ayodhya, Mathura, Maya, Kasi, Kanchi, Avantya, Dwarabha. Kadi ye Saptapuri hai. Kadi ye Saptapuri hai. Ye Saptapuri matlab puri matlab hota hai purva rehna. Jahan par Bhagwan saat sthan par Bhagwan nivas karte hain. Isliye ki Ayodhya hai, Mathura hai, ab log rehte ho. Mathura, Maya, Kasi, Kanchi, Avantya, Dwarabha. ये सात पूरी है, इसलिए उसमें एक है मतलब भगवान यहाँ पर नित्य विद्यमान है।
So there are seven cities in India where Bhagwan is eternally staying. So one is Adyavanti. Avanti means Ujjain, where Lord Krishna he studied under the guidance of Sandipani Muni. 64 days he learned 64 arts. Then Mayapuri. Mayapuri is Haridwar. Then there is Kanchi. Kanchi is actually Vishnu Kanchi in South India. So that is also the place where if you stay there, it will bestow liberation. Kashi, there is also Kashi. Kashi is where we'll be going, I think, Kashi. Varanasi, because it is situated on the trident of Lord Shiva. Then Ayodhya is also the place. If you die here, then you'll get liberation in this place. And also Dwarka. Dwarka is also a place, and then Mathura. But among all these seven places, if you do sadhana bhajan in these seven places, then you will get liberation. But if you do sadhana bhajan in Mathura, then you will get bhakti. So Mathura is superior than these places, but still there are seven important places where Bhagwan eternally resides.
इसलिए हम लोग रामलीला अयोध्या में हम लोग आए हैं, इसलिए कि भगवान किसी जगह में क्यों आए हैं, कहते भगवान राम इस जगत में आने का बहुत सारी कारण है। पहला एक है कहते भगवान राम का जो चरित्र है कभी ये मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम लीला है। भगवान मर्यादा पुरुष और कृष्ण है ये लीला पुरुषोत्तम है और महाप्रभु अवतार्य है। इसलिए कहते जो राम है कहते इनका आदर्श ये मर्यादा है। इसलिए कहते कृष्ण भक्ति साधारण नहीं है। कहते जब तक कोई व्यक्ति राम भक्ति को आदर्श रूप में नहीं लेगा भैया कृष्ण भक्त कृष्ण जैसे तीन जगह में टेढ़े हैं हाँ, इसलिए उनको भक्ति भी बड़ी टेढ़ी है। तू टेढ़ो तेढ़ी टेढ़ी नजरिया, इसलिए उनके सबके सब टेढ़ी टेढ़ी है। और भगवान के राम वो सीधे है, उनका भक्ति भी बड़ी सीधी ताजी भक्ति है। इसलिए कृष्ण भक्ति करने से पहले हमें राम भक्ति का आदर्श को हमें लेना पड़ेगा हाँ? उनका आदर्श है। अब रामायण में पूरी पूरी देखो उनका आदर्श है। कहते एक पुत्र का एक बेटा का प्रति क्या कर्तव्य है, पिता का प्रति क्या कर्तव्य है। अब अभी रामलीला देख रहे थे हाँ, इसलिए पिताजी का आदेश को पालन करने के लिए कहा उन्होंने संपूर्ण अयोध्या को ले लिया। रघुकुल जता सदा चली आई, प्राण जाय बरो वचन न जाय। इसलिए एक आदर्श पुत्र का क्या कर्तव्य पिता का प्रति उन्होंने उसमें दिखाया और एक पत्नी का भी क्या कर्तव्य पति का प्रति उसमें दिखाया। भगवान राम वनवास गए तो सीता भी जिंदगी भर के लिए उसने वनवास चले गए हाँ। इसलिए पति कहते कि भाई का पति क्या कर्तव्य है। राम गए तो पूरा का पूरा लक्ष्मण संपूर्ण परछाई जैसे पूरा प्राण को उन्होंने राम की सेवा में दे दिया। और भरत का कितना बड़ा आदर्श है हाँ? भरत है इसलिए कहते इनका नाम इसलिए कहते एक एक प्रति जो आदर्श को दिखाया है। कहते ये आदर्श का जीवन राम का चरित्र आदर्श का जीवन है। इनके आदर्श को अगर हम ग्रहण करेंगे तो फिर कृष्ण भक्ति में प्रवेश हो सकता है। इनके आदर्श को ग्रहण नहीं करेंगे कृष्ण भक्ति भी ग्रहण करना कठिन है। इसलिए इसमें पूरा आदर्शमय जीवन राम चरित्र है।
सो लॉर्ड राम्स इज कॉल्ड मर्यादा पुरुषोत्तम means he always stayed in the rules and regulations of scriptures, maryada, always followed the limitations of the scriptures. Under Varnashram Dharma, Ram was born in Kshatriya family, so he is always trying to protect his subjects, kill so many demons, and also he was a grihastha. So what is the duty of a grihastha? Take care of the wife, children, mother, father, follow their orders. So he was the ideal example of Varnashram Dharma. Unless we follow this Varnashram Dharma rules and regulations, we cannot advance in spiritual life. So we have a lot to learn from Lord Ram. Shri Krishna is Lila Purushottam. His pastimes are beyond the rules and regulations. We cannot imitate the pastimes of Lord Krishna. We can simply meditate on them. Lord's pastimes, Lord Krishna's pastimes are anusmaraniya, to be remembered all the time. But they are not anukaraniya. You cannot follow them. But Lord Ram's pastimes, they are anukaraniya. You can follow them. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is actually Avadarya Purushottam. He is actually Prema Purushottam. Lord Ram is Maryada Purushottam. Krishna is Lila Purushottam. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Prema Purushottam. In Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you see the combination of Krishna and Ram. His pastimes are very sweet like Krishna's pastimes. At the same time, you can follow them. Because he also taking sannyas, always remaining attached to the wife, in householder life, perfect example, Mahaprabhu also. But anyways, Lord Ram especially we should try to follow. How he served his mother, how he served his father. The father told that go to the forest and stay in the forest for 14 years. Although he was the prince designate, he was to be coronated. But in a moment, he took the dress of an ascetic and he went to the forest. He didn't hesitate to follow the order of the father. Because in the dynasty of Ishvaku, there is a great king called Raghu king. So they are all descendants of Raghu, Raghu Vamsha. So there, Raghukula Riti e Chaliyai, Prana Jai, Vachana Na Jai. That one may lose one's life, but one will not go back on the promise one has given. So Dashrath had given a promise to Kaikeyi that I will give you two benedictions. One time Dashrath was fighting against demons, and that time on behalf of demigod Dashrath was fighting. And he had given Benedict. That time Kaikeyi saved his life. When Dashrath became unconscious, Kaikeyi rode the chariot and took him to a safe place. So she told that I will give you two benedictions. So she asked the two benedictions. First is coronate my son Bharat as the prince, and then also prince designate, and also send Ram to forest. So Dashrath could not go back on his promise. And Ram also, he said, no, I will follow the order of the father. Father persuaded him, don't go, don't go. Also, how much service Sita rendered to Ram. So much service. And you can see the example of Lakshman. Lakshman, day in and day out, all day, all night, he was serving Ram. All day is to collect fruit, flowers, washing clothes, everything to Ram. And at night time, he used to stand in Virasan. There is a stand in Virasan and guard all night long when Sita and Ram took rest. So for 14 years, Lakshman did not eat, did not sleep, and did not see face of any woman. This is strict brahmacharya followed. So these things we should try to bring in our life. That the younger brother must serve the elder brother, regard him as a father, like a father. Wife also, she must be chaste. Sita also, she was always only attached to Ram, not thinking of any other man. If you follow the Ram's ideal, then the whole world will become like Ram Rajya, the kingdom of Ram, and there will be so much happiness.
सत्यानंद चिदात्मा राम एक अर्थ है सभी का हृदय में जो रमण करते हैं बस सभी का हृदय में जो रमण करते हैं और उनमें भी जो जीव सबके सब रमण करते हैं इसलिए राम मतलब जो आराम देते हैं जीव का सुख प्रदान करते हैं इसलिए यदि उनका नाम राम है और जोगी जन जिनको हृदय में हर समय जोगी लोग जिसको हृदय में धारण करते हैं इसलिए उनका नाम राम है और दूसरा भाई का नाम भरत है कहते भरत मतलब विश्व ब्रह्मांड को प्रेम को द्वारा भक्ति को द्वारा जो भरण पोषण करते हैं इसलिए उनका नाम भरत है इसलिए कहते अगर आदर्श रूप में भक्त का चरित्र देखना तो कहते किसको देखो कहते श्री भरत जी को देखो कैसे राम वनवास गए तो पूरा भरत वनवास जैसे उन्होंने जीवन निर्वाह किया है हाँ पूरा वनवास जैसे जीवन निर्वाह किया है इसलिए कहते रामलीला में कहते भक्त का आदर्श रूप में भरत ही उनका भक्त का आदर्श इसलिए उनका भरत नाम रखा गया जो विश्व ब्रह्मांड को भक्ति प्रेम से को जो भरण पोषण करे कहते तीसरा भाई का नाम क्या है लक्ष्मण है कहते लक्ष्मण मतलब होता है लक्ष्मणम लक्ष्मी वर्धनम कहते जो लक्ष्मी को बढ़ाने वाले कहती है लक्ष्मण है ये कहते साई श्री बलदेव प्रभु ये अनंत है हाँ इसलिए ये गुरु रूप में श्री लक्ष्मण है गुरु रूप में ये लक्ष्मण श्री गुरु गुरु का आदर्श श्री लक्ष्मण जी है और छोटा भाई का नाम है शत्रुघ्न शत्रुघ्न मतलब होता है शत्रु को ऊपर जो विजय प्राप्त करता है हमारे बहुत सारे शत्रु हैं काम क्रोध लोभ मोह मद माचर्य कहते ये सब के सब शत्रु है कहते शत्रु को ऊपर जो विजय प्राप्त करते हैं इसका नाम है श्री शत्रुघ्न है इसलिए जो चार भाई नहीं कहते ये चतुर्व्यूह है ये चतुर्व्यूह है इसलिए चतुर्व्यूह में कौन कौन है वासुदेव प्रद्युम्न अनिरुद्ध और सकर्षण वासुदेव प्रद्युम्न अनिरुद्ध ये चतुर्व्यूह ये चार भाई रूप में आए हैं चार भाई कोई अलग नहीं ये भगवान ये चतुर्व्यूह ये चार भाई
So, what is the meaning of the word Ram? Ramante yogina anante satyananda chidatmani iti parabrahma iti rama padenasu parabrahma vidiyate. Because Ram is sports in the heart of all the yogis. He takes pleasure in sporting in the heart of all living entities. So, he's called Ram. He gives happiness to all the living entities. Especially when the yogis mated on the pastimes of Ram, then they receive transcendental happiness in their heart. Also, he is called Aram. Aram means actually gives peace and peace to the mind of all the living entities. Aram galpa vrikshanam viramas sakalam padam aviramas lokanam ramashrimasana prabhav. So, he is giving happiness to all the living entities, especially the devotees and yogis. He is present in the heart of all living entities and giving them happiness. So, his name is Ram. But Ram, his best servant is Bharat. Because Bharat means Bharan means he nourished the whole world. He nourished the whole world by bhakti. So you see that Lord Ram, he said that I will go to the forest and stay in the forest for 14 years. Then Bharat was made the king. But Bharat, he did not rule like a king. What he did, he told Lord Ram, I will not rule. You give me your sandals. So he took the paduka of Lord Ram and placed them on the throne. And then on behalf of the Paduka, he was ruling the kingdom. And he was not staying in palace in Ayodhya. He is settled in nearby small village called Nandigram. And there at Nandigram, we will be going to Nandigram. And there he was putting a mat on the ground and living in a small hut. And every day worshipping the Paduka of Lord Ram, he was ruling. So in this way, he also put on the dress of an ascetic and living like an ascetic and eating only once a day, very little bit avishanna, means little moong dal and rice. He was surviving like an ascetic, and on behalf of Ram, he was ruling. 14 years, he did not enter the palace and observed complete celibacy. So Bharat is also an example of dedication to the elder brother. So then, third brother is Lakshman. Lakshman means Lakshmi Vardhanam. He is increasing the wealth of all living entities. He is also the Guru. What is the real wealth? The real wealth is devotion. So when Lord Ram was walking in the forest, first Ram is to walk, then middle Sita, then Lakshman is to walk. But Ram will see any wild living entities, he will shoot an arrow and kill. So then Lakshman thought any demons would come, Lord Ram would just shoot an arrow and kill them. Lakshman thought that the demons are losing life, they are all living and losing life. So Lakshman told that maybe I will walk ahead. Sita will walk in the middle and you walk behind. So any demons would come, Lakshman, they would look at Lakshman and they will develop devotion. So their lives were saved like that. Understand? They were developing, they were becoming devotees. So this is Lakshman, he is the Adi Guru Tattva. You will see that Balaram, he is Balaram. Then he came as Lakshman. Then he came as Ramanujacharya. In our Sampradaya, Jayatirtha, they are all Shesha Tattva. They are not ordinary persons. They come again and again. Then he came as Nityananda. So he's the Adi Guru Lakshman. He is the one who taught bhakti to Hanuman. Hanuman didn't know how to serve Ram. Lakshman is the guru of even Hanuman. Then the fourth brother is Shatrughna. Shatru means enemies, Ghana means killing. One who kills all the enemies. What are our enemies? Lust, greed, anger, madness, envy. The six Shadripu. The six enemies, they are destroying our devotion, the treasure of devotion, everything. So if we surrender to the Shatrughna, then all our enemies will go away from us. But who are they? Although there are four, they are one. How come? Because the first manifestation is Krishna. From Krishna came Balaram. From Balaram came the first Chaturviha, Pradyumna, Aniruddha, Vasudeva and Mool Sankarshan in Dwarka. Then from Mool Sankarshan came Narayan. From Narayan came Pradyumna, Aniruddha, Vasudeva and Maha Sankarshan. So this Pradyumna, Aniruddha, Vasudeva, Sankarshan. Krishna himself is Vasudev, he has become Ram. Then Balaram himself is Sankarshan, he has become Lakshman. And then Bharat and Shatrughna, they are respectively Pradyumna and Aniruddha. So, they are quadruple manifestations, they are all Shankha Chakra Gada Padma. Understand? So, they are all one actually, although they are one different. Krishna, Ram himself has expanded in this three extra forms to serve himself. Just like Krishna himself has become Balaram, like that. So we should understand their ontological position in this manner.
इसलिए कि जो भगवान राम हैं, कि जगत में आने का उनको बहुत सारे कारण हैं। जो साधारण कारण क्या है? वे साधारण कारण हैं, मतलब जदा जदा ही धर्मस्य ग्लानिर् भवति भारत अद्भुतान् मधर्मस्य तदात्मान् सृजाम्यहम् परित्राणाय साधुनां विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि। इसलिए कहते इसी जगत में जिस समय रावण जिस समय बड़ा अत्याचार कर रहा था जगत में, तो मिताल का मजा दिया रावण ने, हाँ, जोर जबरदस्ती सुंदरी सुंदरी लड़की को जहाँ मिला वहीं छीन छीन करके अपना उसने पत्नी बनाया और लास्ट में उसने सबको बड़े त्याग से बैठा दिया। लास्ट में ऋषि मुनियों को बड़े त्याग से बैठा दिया, बोले इनको भी छोड़ेंगे नहीं, इनको ही देना पड़ेगा। जब ऋषि मुनियों को बड़े त्याग से बैठाए, ऋषि मुनियों ने क्रोधित होकर बोले हमारे ऊपर भी त्याग से। इसलिए उन्होंने क्या किया, अपना खून को, हाँ, ऋषि मुनियों ने अपना खून को लेकर एक कलसी के अंदर रखा, बोले उसको दे देना रावण को, यही इसका मृत्यु का कारण बनेगा। जो संतों के ऊपर भी त्याग, जो भजन करने वाले, जब उन्हें रावण को खून का, हाँ, जो पात्र जब दिया, बोले ऋषियों ने अभिशाप दिया, ये तो जरूर होगा, इसे न रहेगा मांस, न बजेगी बंसुरी। उसने बोले उसको मिट्टी को नीचे उसको गाड़ दो, मिट्टी को नीचे गाड़ दो और मिट्टी को नीचे गाड़ दो तो वहां से हो गया सीता, वहां से सीता हुई, इसलिए उसके ऊपर में सीता हुई तो फिर वही सीता ही रावण का रावण आया और सीता जी को उठा कर ले गया और सीता ही बन गई, काल बन गई और काल बन करके पूरा रावण वंश एकदम ध्वंस कर दिया। इसलिए कहते एक कारण है जगत में भगवान प्राणी का बोले परित्राण आएगा साधुना, अपना भक्तों को रक्षा करना और विनाशाय च दुष्कृता, जितने दुष्ट है राक्षस वंश है भगवान राम आए पूरा राक्षस वंश को उन्होंने खत्म कर दिया, कर ये कारण जगत में आने का।
सो एज महाराज टोल्ड दैट इन भगवद गीता कृष्ण हैज सेड यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानम अधर्मस्य तदात्मानम संजाय परित्राणाय साधुनाम विनाशाय च दुष्कृताम धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे। Whenever there is a decline in religion, an increase in irreligion, to protect the religious principles and to destroy the demons, Bhagavan Shri Krishna himself comes. So you'll see that Lord Ram also advented because there was a demon by the name Ravan. Ravan, Rava means actually weeping, who makes the whole world weep by his atrocious activities called Ravan. So Ravan making whole world weep, he was committing atrocities on Brahmanas, cows, killing the cows, harassing the Brahmanas, saintly persons, everyone, demigods were scared of him. If they would hear the name Ravan, then Yamaraj himself is to run. We are also scared of Yamaraj, death personified. But if Ravan will come, and if any Brahman, any king is performing sacrifice, and demigods have come to attend the sacrifice, to take their share of the Havishana, so then if they will hear Ravan has come, they all used to become birds. Immediately Indra will hide himself, become a peacock, and then Varun will become a swan, and then this way Kuber will become Bharadwaj, and Yamaraj sometimes becomes so scared of Ravan that he used to become a crow. So Yamaraj one time when Ravan came, Yamaraj became a crow. So then Ravan went away, then he thanked the crows, because I took your form, Ravan didn't kill me. So he told the crows that you'll have a long life, you'll probably never die. And if anyone will give you some rice, it will go to the forefathers. Like that.
उस घर में जो वायु है, उस घर में झाड़ लगाया करता था, अग्नि उसको कपड़ा साफ करता था, हाँ, नारद जी आकर बिना यंत्र में उसका गुणगान करता था, ब्रह्मा आकर के वेद पाठ सुनाया करता था, इसलिए जिस समय हनुमान को बांध करके ले गया, हाँ, मेघनाथ, हनुमान जी देखा जो काल को, वो पैर के नीचे काल को, नीचे दबा के रखा काल को, और चारी तरफ जो हनुमान जी दिखाया, जितने देवता दीपाल सबको बांध करके रावण रखा, सबके सब हनुमान जी को प्रार्थना कर रहे थे हमको यहाँ से निकालो, हमको यहाँ से किस तरह से निकालो। एक शंकर जी को, हाँ, एक शंकर जी को पूजा करता था और जो लंकिनी दुर्गा को अपना दरबार बन कर रखता था, ये सब दुनिया को उसने पूरा बांध कर रखा था रावण।
तो रावण वाज सो पावरफुल दैट डेमिगॉड्स लाइक वरुण and Agni, they used to clean his house. Varun used to sweep his house. And Agni used to wash his, do his laundry, clothes. He was become his dhobi, understand? And different demigods were doing menial chores. Someone used to fetch water. Some used to do gardening, like this. He had engaged them in menial services. And some demigods he had just tied up to the trees and bound their hands and legs and put a cloth in their mouth. They could not shout, understand? And also, except he used to worship Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is a worshipable deity. Even Goddess Durga used to guard his fort, Lanka fort. She was a beautiful goddess, Durga. She had become Lankini and guarding his forest. And also when Hanuman went to Lanka, he saw that Meghnad, the son of Ravan, had pressed his head on the in the time personified Kala Purusha. And he had put his foot on the head of Kala Purusha. So everyone was scared of that. So they all prayed to Hanuman, please save us, this Ravan is tormenting us. So Ravan actually causing so much havoc. So sages became tired of his activities. So they decided that, so then he told that if you want to chant Harinam or chant your Gayatri mantras, read Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita, then you will have to pay tax. You know, just like the Muslims had put tax on Hindus called jizya tax. If you want to be Hindu, then you have to pay a special tax. Otherwise you have to convert to Islam. So Ravan also like that, he was also like a Muslim. So he was actually told, he told the sages that you have to give some tax. What money the sages have? They have no money, no bank balance, nothing. So therefore the sages said, we'll give tax, we'll give our blood. So they took out their blood and they put in one in pot. And that earthen pot, golden pot, they gave it to Ravan. This is our tax, our blood is our tax. And then Ravan became very scared. They are giving the blood, they are cursing me. This blood will destroy you. So Ravan said, better that this pot of golden pot of blood, I should bury it in the ground. So Ravan, he buried it in the ground. So one day Janak Maharaj had no son, no daughter. So Janak Maharaj in Nepal was very worried how to have a progeny. Then some sages told him that, and also there is no rain also. Because if the king has no daughter, no son, how will there be rain? If the king is not having son, then there will be no rain also. So therefore the sages told him, you take a golden plow and you plow. And he was plowing and he found in the plow hit something, tuck sound came. He said, what is there underneath? He took out that golden pot, a golden box, and that box there was Sita. Beautiful young girl was there. So Sita was called a Yonija. A Yonija means not brought from any mother's womb. She's just found in the box. So that Sita, she became the cause of Ravan's destruction. Ravan, he actually first tried to marry Sita because he tried to, there was a big, big, big bow, and that bow Sita used to lift. If you go to Janakpur sometime, Nepal, then Sita used to lift that. One time Sita was playing with a ball, her ball went underneath that bow, and it was Lord Shiva's bow. No one could lift it, 100 people could not lift it. But Sita lifted it by left hand and took out her ball from underneath when she was just 2 or 3 years old. So then then when Janak Maharaj saw this, he said, this girl is so strong, she will need a stronger husband. So he put the condition that only a man who can lift this bow and string it, she will be able to marry my daughter. So Ravan also came to marry, but Ravan was trying to lift by one hand. He could not lift the bow. Then he put 2 hands, then 3 hands, then he put 10 hands, then another 10 hands. He could barely lift the bow, but it fell down on his chest and he was profusely bleeding with blood. Then Janak Maharaj became say, Ravan may die. He is the son of a Brahman. I'll get the scene of Brahma. He told Sita, you rescue him. Then Sita came with left hand. She lifted the bow and kept it away and saved the life of Ravan. So Ravan was trying to lift. It was so heavy that Ravan is dhoti pass number one, number two, everything. Understand? And then finally ran away from there. Understand? So Ravan tried to marry, but he could not do. But Ram very easily strung the bow and then he married Sita.
So many pastimes, Ram pastimes. So now you will go to take darshan, you know, where Ramchandra took birth, you know. And this Saraju Nadi here, like this Vrindavan, there is the Yamuna flowing, here is a Saraju Nadi also here flowing here. Saraju is very, very pure and very holy river. So if anybody took bath, you can take you to your club. You can take bath in Saraju. Yesterday you took bath in Kolkata?
Gomati Ganga.
Gomati Ganga. Yeah, Gomati. Today also took bath also Saraju Nadi, you know, very pure Nadi. Ramchandra took bath there. And this is the Adhir. So, you know, and there are so many places you will be going now. Take darshan. Now pasta wait for you. Yes, pasta. Pasta is very very. इसलिए चल हरे कृष्णा ये जो रूम को है ना हमको खाली करना पड़ेगा ये रूम को क्योंकि पास में ये रूम था नहीं हम बहुत कष्ट से ये रूम लिया था आप लोगों का रूम ठीक है आप लोग रखा लेकिन हम लोग इसी रूम में जो लोग रुके हुए वो सामान को इसी घर में रख देते हैं इसी जो इसी घर इसी रूम में रख लेते हैं अंदर घर का ये जो घर है इसे हाल घर को पूरा थाक बेटा थाक हमारे शुद्ध एक घंटा हाल घर को खाली रखना पड़ेगा फिर आप लोग सबका घर रहे हम वापस आ करके अपना सब बैठक बांधना वापस आ करके फिर